Welcome to the celebration of the 26th Sunday in ordinary time. Our reading today is found on page number 216 in the Missalette. Second collection today is for the annual Catholic School Appeal. Today's announcements. There'll be no religious education classes next Sunday, October 7th. Confirmation candidates and sponsors meeting Sunday, October 14th from 6 to 7:30 p.m. Are you interested in becoming a Catholic? Are you an adult who has not yet received the sacraments of baptism, first Eucharist, or confirmation? Are you a child 7 years or older who has not yet received baptism, reconciliation, or first Eucharist? We are accepting candidates for the RCIA-RCIC program. Call the parish office or contact Lucy Marcel for more information. If you didn't have a chance to shop at our White Elephant sale yesterday, or if you'd just like to browse again, it will be open in the parish hall after Mass this morning. All items are half off.
No.
Such a great deal. Please take a moment and welcome someone around you. Say hello.
Welcome. Hi, Tim. You're awesome. On a scale of 1 to 10 years old. I won't begin next week.
Our opening hymn is number 537, All Creatures of Our God and King. Please stand and join us singing our opening hymn.
Good morning to you all.
Good morning, Father.
This morning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us seek God's peace, God's forgiveness, before we begin our prayer this morning. I confess,
O Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, O Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hasting to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord came down in a cloud and spoke to Moses. Taking some of the spirit that was on Moses, the Lord bestowed it on the 70 elders. And as the spirit came to rest on them, they prophesied. Now two men, one named Eldad and the other Medad, were not in the gathering, but had been left in the camp. They too had been on the list, but had not gone out to the tent. Yet the Spirit came to rest on them also, and they prophesied in the camp. So when a young man quickly told Moses, Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp, Joshua, son of Nun, who from his youth had been Moses' aide, said, Moses, my Lord, stop them. But Moses answered him, are you jealous for my sake? Would that all the people of the Lord were prophets? Would that the Lord might bestow his spirit on them all? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Come now, you rich. Weep and wail over your impending miseries. Your wealth has rotten away. Your clothes have become moth-eaten. Your gold and silver have corroded. Now that corrosion will be a testimony against you. It will devour your flesh like a fire. You have stored up treasure for the last days. Behold, the wages you withheld from the workers who harvested your fields are crying aloud, and the cries of the harvesters have reached the ears of the Lord of hosts. You have lived on earth in luxury and pleasure. You have fattened your hearts for the day of slaughter. You have condemned. You converted the righteous one. He offers you no resistance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Anyone who gives you a cup of water to drink because you belong to Christ, amen I say to you, will surely not lose his reward. Whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him if a great millstone were put around his neck and he were thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life maimed than with two hands to go into Gehenna, into the unquenchable fire. If your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life crippled than with 2 feet to be thrown into Gehenna. If your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. Better for you to enter into the kingdom of God with one eye than with 2 eyes to be thrown into Gehenna, where their worm does not die and the fire is not quenched. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning once again.
Good morning, Father.
Friday, I attended Mass at a local college, and the first reading, in fact, at the Mass, first reading for the Mass was the reading that many people really know so well. It comes from the book of Ecclesiastes, and begins with the words, "There is a time for everything, a time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to uproot plants, a time to laugh, a time to cry." How many of you have heard of that reading? Very popular with a lot of people, and they also use it a lot for funerals. And the priest out there was speaking about this reading, and he said that the hardest thing, however, is not the right time to do certain things. We all know that that is true, there's a time for everything. But discerning, and that's what the big word, discerning the right time to make a decision is the very hardest thing that we all need to learn. He spoke about three things. He says, for example, as you get older, you cannot drive, right? And telling the person, the senior citizen, that you're going to pull your license, you're not going to drive, because you can make, you know, get into an accident or injure some people, is a hard thing. The time to discern and say, it is time that I give up my license, I cannot drive anymore. He spoke about downsizing. You know, when your kids are going to college and things like that, the decision, the discernment to say, it's time to get a smaller house, because that's what we're going to manage. Some of the easy things sometimes to do. Then he spoke about deciding to give up certain things, to yield into certain things and just say, that's it, I'm done, I need to give that up. Especially the things that always bring us problems in our relationships, in our, you know, the way we deal with other people. Saying to yourself, you know, something that is bringing you down, oftentimes, but you cannot get rid of it. You know, saying and deciding is the right time to cut. That myself is the same. It's not a little thing. And Jesus always has that as his big lesson to the disciples. Discernment. When is the right time to cut things and say, to change my life? And for a while now, Jesus has been having big problems with the disciples. He is going to die, according to the Gospel of Mark that we are listening to. And so he's beginning to prepare his disciples for his death. He's telling them about what it means to be disciples of Christ, telling them what it means to be a leader as a Christian. Last Sunday told them it means to serve. To lead is to serve. And actually he was trying to tell them that, and they are all, you know, speaking to her Sunday's Gospel, last Sunday's Gospel. They are thinking about who is the greatest among us then. And he asked them, and then they were kind of quiet. And he says, if you want to be the greatest, you have to be the last of all. You have to be the servant of all. Not an easy thing to do. Self-denial, serving others, is not an easy thing to do as a leader. Today, the evangelist John, one of those four evangelists, John, one of his most beloved disciples, comes to him, running, and says, out there we found an unknown disciple who is doing exactly the same thing that we're doing. Doing the ministry of healing, doing a lot of good things, gifted as we are. But he does not follow us. He's not part of our group. He's not part of our circle, the disciples of Jesus. We must stop him. Who is he? The disciples always have an athlete mentality of competition in them. Us and not them. Us versus them. If you don't belong to their group, that's why they're arguing about who is the greatest. If you don't belong to their circle, you're nobody else. It happens oftentimes in society. A certain group thinks that everything belongs to them. Others are not as gifted as they are. Sometimes even thinking that they're superior, are better at things than others. And Jesus says to them, no. Each one of us has been gifted in a special way. Do not refuse them. They too can be influenced by God's Spirit. God gives us his wishes abundantly. Not in each one does not have to have the same measure, but each other people also have their own giftedness. See them, learn from them, exchange what you have. Accept other people's giftedness and talents too. They too can preach. And that's why he says you have to be aware of the scandal of selfishness and always looking at yourself. That's why in the Gospel it says that if somebody has that kind of mentality, it's better for them to be thrown into the always extract others and the giftedness of others. That is exactly what is going on in the first reading today. Moses, you know, Joshua, his most dedicated aid comes to him. The Holy Spirit has come out to 70 elders in the first reading of Numbers. Two people were not part of that gathering where the Spirit went to that kind of gathering of 70 elders. They were outside that camp. And then one of the people sees that these two other people who are not part of the circle are also prophesying. They have the gift of prophecy. They come to Moses running and say, "Who are they? Stop them. They are not part of that group that was in the, you know, given the Spirit." And Moses says, "Are you jealous? Because God gives abundantly, has given to somebody who is not of that group. If all the prophets, if all had the Spirit of God, that's a good thing. The things that come to us oftentimes, when we see the gifted of others, the giftedness of others, and we don't accept it, discerning, to learn, to listen, sometimes to be humble, to notice that others have gifts that can enrich us. Sometimes that's the thing that all of us struggle with. And so the creeping in of hate, jealousy, envy, when I see others flourish, do good things. The readings tell us to look beyond ourselves today. Self-denial, accepting of the giftedness of others. How do we do that? How do we discern how to do that right there? The disciples are being asked to yield to power, especially the power that always makes them focus on just themselves. So we could all ask ourselves questions this week in order to kind of live out the gospel reading today. How do you discern when to turn away from yourself and listen to others? How do you accept the giftedness of the people around you, your family? Is it hard sometimes to see? What obstructs you from seeing the giftedness of the people around you? I spoke to the 4 o'clock crowd and also the 8 o'clock about the church. The church has always suffered from that, always looking only on itself, has not accepted the giftedness of others. These days the church is bleeding because of things like that. Misuse of power, only focusing on themselves. How can we change that? As Christians, we are the church. We are the people who make up the church. Always in giving of ourselves, others, not holding on to our own giftedness, but also accepting the giftedness of others. So how are we going to do that in our lives today? This week is going to really depend on you. Now we try to live out the gospel message for yourself this week. May God help us in that. In the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May we now stand and profess our faith. For we believe in one God,
the Father the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For our sin, for our salvation, he came down from heaven.
By the power of the Spirit, he
incarnated the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried.
And rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures.
He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church.
I look forward to
baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Amen.
Let's now lift up to the Lord some of our prayers and petitions.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that we may be receptive to the gift of the Spirit and be transformed by the Spirit's work in us, so that God's mercy, compassion, and presence may be manifest. We pray to the
Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
For a renewed sense of mission, that we may each use our unique gifts and opportunities to share God's love through words, deeds of healing, offers of hospitality. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For openness to the Spirit, that we may welcome all whom God calls to serve the community of faith and ministry, and listen for the Spirit's prompting about new forms and styles of service needed to meet the hungers of human hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all young people, that God's Spirit will fill them with wisdom and understanding, so that they may correctly perceive the values of life and not be seduced by wealth, fame, or power. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a new understanding of money, that God will help us to recognize money as a means to fulfill our responsibilities rather than an end in itself. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all victims of abuse, that God will heal their injuries and memories and help them find safety and protection from further harm. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our deceased loved ones, may they rest in eternal peace.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, who bless our needs and intentions before you this day, guide us in drawing ever closer to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Our preparation of the gift hymn is number 425. How great thou art, number 425.
Thank you.
Let us pray willing that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, the mighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
Grant to us, O God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you. That through it the world kingdom of blessings may be laid open before us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just to give our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, for the Father, mighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For our compassion for the waywardness that is ours. He humbled himself and was born of the Virgin Mary. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from an ending death. By rising from the dead, he gave us eternal life. So the angels and the saints, thrones and dominions, hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory without end as we are praying. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts of worship for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, a holy command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night Jesus was betrayed, he himself took bread and gave thanks. He broke it. He gave it to his disciples and friends, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you."
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives life to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his way.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup again, giving thanks and praise. He gave it to his friends and disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives life to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those trust in his way.
The mystery of faith. Passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. We look forward to his second coming. We pray thanksgiving, his holy and living sacrifice. Look with prayer upon the oblation of your Church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, may be filled with his Holy Spirit, become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us a divine offering to you, that we obtain an inheritance with the elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, the blessed Apostles, the glorious martyrs, Saint Boniface, Saint Joseph, all the saints of whose constant intercession in your presence we rely on paying God. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation to pray, O Lord, advance peace and salvation in our families and in the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, the servant Pope Francis, Bishop Robert, the bishops, the entire clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Listen graciously to the prayer of the families that have been before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, especially Paul Harold, who remember this Mass, all who are pleasing to you that are passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, from whom all good things come. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
Trusting that God is in our midst, we now pray the word of our Savior himself to us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grant us peace in our families and in our days. With the help of your mercy, free us from sin, save us from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
And Lord Jesus Christ, you say to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but in the faith of your Church. Grant us the peace, the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you
all.
Extend to one another a sign of
Thank you.
Jesus, the Lamb of God, behold, he who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to be in the room, but only say the word of my soul.
Union song is number 665, Loving and Forgiving.
Oh,
Let us stand. May His heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs to the glory of Christ, to whose suffering we are united, whenever we proclaim His death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I must end it and remain in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Good week, everyone.
You too, Father.
I'm asked not to forget to check out the white elephant, okay? Just one more time. Our closing hymn is number 397, Be Thou My Light, number 397.